podcast is a pretty lurid, loose term, lurid term.
I'm not sure if I'm doing a vlog or a podcast, and I really hate this angle, but
so show Gabe your impression of me again. Show Gabe your impression.
That's not bad. Really? I feel like you have to outplay everything about Paul.
I think it's a little...
Just like, hey, have you ever seen Welcome Back, Connor?
I think you're making me look better
I went
than
to Illinois, and I used to chomp on girls' heels.
Seemed like you've had a high heel or two against your throat and enjoyed it.
I've had a few high heels in my mouth. But...
Ooh.
That's a Woody Allen thing.
High heels
dating
is what
therapist,
he calls his boyfriend.
And he goes, you're the perfect woman. You understand all my problems, and you know who I am, and... You understand my need to have your high heels in my mouth?
Love it.
Anyways, hey, speaking of
best references from Paul.
But wait a second. I have to make a correction from the last. Wait, hold on, real quick. Did you get my 5%er? You're not going to get this reference, but I can explain it to you.
Okay.
Only black audiences would get this reference.
5%er.
Did you hear my. I sent you that clip. I didn't expect you to listen to it, but you were saying you wanted a longer clip, so I gave you a 54-minute clip.
Oh, yeah.
And you said something about how Muslims were cheap. And when I listened to the video, I thought of a punchline, and I went, why didn't I fucking Muslims only tip 5%?
Why, is that what they're supposed to tithe or whatever?
There's a sect of black audience.
Like in a restaurant, Muslims
only. Yeah, well, he's a waiter, and he says Muslims are cheap, and I said they only tip 5%.
Middle Eastern people, I don't know what they...
What kind of
they have to be
practice.
Well, that's
it's like a pizza and salads.
That's fun stuff.
Yeah. I kill it, you know what I mean?
It's a sect of Islam called the 5%ers.
Did you almost say Islamism? One time I heard a guy, honestly, he didn't know, the term Islam, and he was like, no, she started practicing Muslimism, swear to God, an adult human
They
being.
Tried really hard.
Yeah, so the joke is...
So
self-explanatory
so
after
case.
I explain it to you. Self-explanatory once I explain it to you. Here's the other thing. A couple weeks ago, we talked about Shirley Temple and her Me Too moment in her book, right? Who's the star of the show now?
Is that better? You like that angle better?
Do you feel more comfortable that way?
Yeah.
Okay.
Nailed it.
But how are we going to... But when you become famous, how are people going to know, believe us, that you were on the show?
It's kind of distinct.
Because you're going to deny knowing me.
You dipshit.
Okay. Yeah, but that's uninteresting. I'm going to cut that part out. But So Shirley Temple. So I need to correct something I said a couple weeks ago in case Shirley Temple sues me from the grave.
She's been dead for ever.
Okay. So, she was not finger banged. She was not finger banged. You know that drink? She was not finger banged.
3 minutes until
when she was
Paul
12. When she was 12, a studio executive pulled out his penis. And she laughed at it, and then he kicked her out of the office because, you know, he got feelings about a 12-year-old laughing at his comment. Yeah, that's her story. That's her Me Too moment.
She was savage, dude.
Oh, yeah, brutal. Brutal. Oh, also, when I was doing research on her to back up what I... Because I was, you know... So...
Research on her. That's what you call it.
I found pictures of her in blackface.
Yeah.
Oh, really?
So if you ever do your blackface bit, you record it, we'll put it on the thing, and we'll get Shirley Temple's face... And blackface for the
company. You have a blackface?
There's, it's old. I didn't do it that much. It worked, but I just noticed, in 5-minute sets, sometimes I'd be like, only talk about black people for 5 minutes. And I just didn't want to do that, you know? I feel like there would be people that was like, I feel like all he does is talk about black people.
It gets a little obsessive.
Like, if you did that bit every time, it'd probably get old. You'd probably seem racist.
Well, it's also like this. Have you ever heard, I don't want to say who, but, because they bring him up too much on the show, but sometimes this fellow will get very self-deprecating,
Oswald?
And it'll get very dark,
sorry.
And it starts making the audience uncomfortable. Like, if he obsessed, if he pounds on it too much,
Tom,
it just gets uncomfortable.
That's my dad's name.
Oh, yeah, we're talking about him. He's a good audience member, because he gets my references.
I think, I don't know if he gets them. He just is a good audience member because he, fake laughs.
He likes my act.
Don't you ever tell me that Tom may have faked my joke. Ever again.
Hey,
Gabe. Inside.
Anyways, I brought a friend to Rebar, and he like just kept talking about you for the rest of the night. That was this week.
Didn't he bring me up at all? This is bullshit.
No, it was you. He's like, show's over.
He didn't bring me up. He didn't bring me up at all.
We left before you went up.
Shows yeah, he did. He was like, who was that dude that looked like a Russian, like, ketamine dealer? She was like, oh, that's Paul.